do-do-do.
Generation game, is it?
It's a bit, yeah.
Just run a short, just walks. Probably. Only a wee clip for the boss one, please. That's what I'm doing here. I've got that shake. I've got that shake to begin with. It comes a pack of staves to shoot the people. That's it. The first stage I can build up to the end to. That's all I do. I'm safe perishing it. It's not going to go anywhere. But, so, net now, I've got all the hoops in it. Two ends in. Only I have to go up and flag. Have a look and you see that inside what they call a close in here. You feel it's like a line right in there, it's cutting the wood.
Yeah.
See, so if you look at the end, both the ends. The ends are both chamfered, so look, they're both cut in. There's always a big side which goes inside the cast. You don't have a small chamfer here. So this, see the growth here, that actually slides inside this one here. And that's the only thing. Any kind of tongue and groove you'll see in any barrel. There's no glue, there's no magic tricks, it's no tongue and groove wood. You've seen it's a pack of steel. The only thing that holds it together is pressure of the hoops. As simple as that, sort of that. So, if you like the barrel set, I'll finish it off with. in the hoop. Drop the hoop. You know, for near-house purposes, you'll notice that they're all heavy hoops. Two rivets. What you always do is put the two rivets in the pung hole. And the guys in the varices, they're up the hand, they can climb up, they know that class 7 pung up. Where the hoops have got to there.
Yep.
There's no gaps here, the gaps at the top. It's nice to see just the pressure all of a sudden in.
Thank you.
Guaranteed.
Where's the bug?